welcome to a special edition of The Drop. Today we're celebrating Team GB's superstars of the Rio 2016 Games. These are my top five personal highlights from Brazil, and I hope you enjoyed them as much as me. First up, we've got the first gold of the Games for the side, Adam Peaty, with a world record time in the pool. This was the one I think that set off the gold rush. Peaty's the current world and Commonwealth champion, so it was only a matter of time before he added the Olympic title too. No one gets near him in the breaststroke, and at just 21, he's going to be dominating for several more years to come. Next, it's Max Whitlock. What a sensational Games for the Essex lad. The 23-year-old became an absolute legend in the space of 2 hours in the gymnastics. He secured Britain's first individual gold in the sport on the floor and then went and smashed it on the pommel horse. What an achievement. The whole team deserve a massive pat on the back, though, really, as there were medals all around, especially 16-year-old Amy Tinkler with a bronze. Probably next up at number three, and it's only because we've seen so much of them in the last few years dominating, it's Britain's golden couple of cycling, Laura Trott and Jason Kenny. Kenny became the joint highest gold medal winner in Team GB history in Rio after pipping teammate Callum Skinner to the sprint gold and then smashing another gold in the Kirin. Six golds now to his name, level with Sir Chris Hoy. His wife-to-be Laura Trott secured two golds in the women's team pursuit and the Omnium. And it says it all, really, when the whole of the squad managed to get a medal, truly outstanding. I actually end up getting bored of their success in the velodrome.
I thought, you know, I could do it. Like the stars had to align, everything had to go right for me to be able to achieve that. And once we got the world record in the team pursuit qualification, I was thinking, this could happen. This could happen here. And it did, and it was one world record after another, and then that obviously brought us the team pursuit gold. And then in the Omnium, I felt really good, I felt really strong, and it all came together. And I was so pleased that it did all come together on the day.
Next up, it's many people's favourites, and he's a totally top fella, but he doesn't quite make number one for me. Mo Farah's exploits are just shy of my favourite moment. Mo is a double Olympic champion now, a double-double Olympic champion, actually, to go with being a double-double world champion. Sounds quite confusing, really, but basically he holds the 5K and the 10K golds in both events. In effect, he's done the quadruple-double. Geez, the guy is more or less Superman when it comes to distance running. The Africans cannot get near him. Coach Alberto Salazar deserves much of the credit, though, for transforming the potential into a medal machine and harnessing that kick on the last lap to blow away the field. Let's hope by 2017, when he retires from the 5K and 10K at the next World Championships, we're calling him Sir Mo Farah. Pick of the lot, though, for me has got to be Justin Rose, winning golf's medal in that epic final hole battle with Open champion Henrik Stenson. Justin got the better of his Ryder Cup teammate to clinch the sport's first gold medal in over a century. I remember watching and covering this one, and the drama was just intense, even if you weren't that into golf. To top it off, though, he's actually one of the nicest chaps out there. So this one goes down as my favourite of the Games. And that Sunday, we also had Andy Murray winning, but I couldn't put him in because he just wins for fun these days. He already had the gold from London 2012, and he pretty much owns Wimbledon these days. That was an epic match against Juan Martín del Potro, though. So that's that then. 27 golds in our most successful Olympics ever. Will it be beaten next time around? Roll on Tokyo 2020. Thanks for watching this, and if you agree or disagree with anything, hit me up in the comments below. Until next time, let's leave you with some stunners from Rio who we can totally appreciate now. See you next time. Mike can't handle it. It's the new dance move, it's the knee exercise move. Oh.